All right, welcome everybody. I'm so excited about this call. I've been like thinking about it and like meditating on it now for like a solid week, and I'm just really stoked. So I hope that everybody was able to listen to the Trina Gray video, or watch the Trina Gray video. Because a lot of what I'm going to talk about tonight is kind of piggyback on what
she said.
So if you did not listen to it yet, make sure, tonight or tomorrow, go back and listen to it. And I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to mute everybody just for now. So So when people listen to the recording, then you don't get a lot of that horrible screeching feedback. Okay, so a couple things before we get started. I wanted to cover some things that are coming up that we need to be aware of and prepared for. Number one is tomorrow is the deadline, or well, not the deadline. It's the first day to register for the 2017 Success Club trip to Punta Cana, which is going to be fantastic. So if you want to be on that trip, I highly recommend that you get on. I want to say that the registration opens at 9 o'clock in the morning, and you want to register right away because it's going to sell out basically. If you don't have the money, it's like a $300 deposit. If you don't have the money for that right now, what I recommend is you just pay attention until you hear or get the news that it's sold out, and then get your name on the wait list, because to get on the wait list, you don't have to pay anything. And if you get on the wait list right away, as soon as it goes waitlisted and you hop on the wait list, chances are a lot higher that you'll be able to go. Your name will come up. But keep in mind that you're going to need that $300 when your name does come up. I think you have 90 hours, I think, to accept or decline the offer, for lack of a better word. So just kind of keep that in mind, but that's an option too, just purposefully waiting so that, you can get on the wait list and be one of the first on the wait list. I highly recommend these trips. I've talked about that a gazillion times, so I'm not going to go into detail as to why, but if you can at all possible, get your booty on that trip. It's going to be really fun. Beachbody gets to reward you for all the hard work you do already to build your business. You're already doing the work. You're already working, right? You're already hitting Success Club. You might as well get rewarded for it. Also, tomorrow night is a sneak peek into coaching. It's the 1 hour event that the Rank the Bank group, I know some of us are in the Rank the Bank group right now, that's being put on by the Rank the Bank group, but everyone is invited to utilize this. So if you have people who've been interested or on the fence about coaching, this is a great opportunity to invite them and let them see. And every presenter this time is going to be super top coaches. So they're going to get great information from people who have been wildly successful with this. So I highly recommend that you invite to that. I think it starts at 6:30 Pacific Standard Time. Is it standard or are we in daylight right now? I always get those mixed up. But anyway, 6:30 California time right now. Okay. Oh, the Teen Cup registration is coming up as well. I think that is tomorrow too. The opening to register for the Teen Cup. So if you have people in mind, maybe you want to start a team and you want to be the captain of a team, I say go for it. Most of our coaches who've participated in the Team Cup will tell you that it really pushes you. If you let it, it will push you to do more and bigger things with your business than you have in the past. So I highly recommend you do that as well. And I think that is tomorrow too. I didn't write the date down, but I'm pretty sure it's tomorrow. I shared in our team page a video by Carl Deichler that he posted yesterday about a contest he's doing. Did you guys see that? For the Beachbody Performance Line supplement set. And there's like three things that you need to do. One is be registered on a Team Cup this week, earn at least one Success Club point this week. And then there was something else. Oh, share that video so that he sees that it's been shared. And you'll get entered to win the entire Beachbody Performance Line of supplements, which is really cool. I've been using the recovery formula after my hammer and chisel workouts, and I am not nearly as sore as I normally am starting a brand new program. Normally, like the first major leg day, like I can't walk for 3 days, right? Like I look like an old lady, but that hasn't happened to me this time. And I'm pretty darn sure it's because of that recovery, because it happens to me every other time. So that's really good stuff. Okay, so, and I also wanted to say a big congratulations to our newest Emerald coach, Stephanie. Yay! Good job. She's been a coach. We were just talking before everybody else hopped on. She's been a coach all of like 2 months, and she's already an Emerald coach. That's a big deal. So I just wanted to say congrats, and that's the way we do it. It's exciting. All right, so let's dive in. And I know I talked about goal setting on the last team call of 2016, and I kind of felt like I like jumped all over the place with it, and I felt kind of bad, I'm just being honest, because I didn't feel like it was really concise like information. So I'm hoping that tonight I do a better job, like getting my what I want to get across, my message across. But I was already wanting to talk about this again. And then I was, you know, I listened to the Trina Gray video. And I mean, how amazing was that? She said so many things that I was just like, light bulb, like awesome, awesome information. And I've been so like, touched all day long watching everybody's happiness boards being posted. I'm just curious, like, I'm actually going to unmute everybody because I want to talk about this for a second. Okay, I've unmuted you guys. I want to hear about the happiness board, and if anybody had like a big like aha moment when you were creating, going through your pictures and really thinking about what makes you happy, like what is the most what things in your life like bring you the most joy? Does anybody want to volunteer
right now? That's a bit
I was looking through my pictures, and I was looking for like all the different trips that we went on this past year, and I realized when I was looking at the pictures that it wasn't really the trip that I was taking, but the people that I was with and like the memories that I made. Because like the pictures that gave me warm fuzzy thoughts were like all the people that, you know, I care about in my life and are my friends and family. So yeah, I thought it would be trips, honestly.
Yeah, the people really do make a big difference. Because I've been on trips before with people I didn't really like, and it's just not fun. They either make or break it, right?
It's probably because I'm a stay-at-home mom. I'm like, I need to go somewhere.
Anybody else? Was anybody surprised at something or anything like just kind of stand out about your kind of trend in your pictures? Anyone? You guys are so quiet. Oh my gosh. All right, so I'll tell you, I was a little surprised when I noticed that about 50% of my pictures were outside. And the reason why I was surprised, I mean, I know if you asked me, like, do you like being outside? I would say yes. But I don't get to spend that much time outside. I very rarely have time to just go enjoy being outside. And when I was looking through all my pictures, those were the ones that just kept like, oh, I remember that day. Like, I remember that walk. Or, you know, I remember like going to the Great your woods, or you know what I mean? Like, it's just things that were like popping out that really smile were all outside. And I work an 8-hour job inside, especially like right now in the winter time where it gets dark so early, you know, it's hard to get outside and really enjoy it. So that one kind of stuck out to me. I was, I guess, not really surprised as much as just like, it was like a kind of like, wow, because the whole point obviously of our doing that exercise was to identify, it's kind of like helps you identify your why in a way, right? Because I can see like when I build my business to the point that I can quit my job, like today was a holiday, so I was home and I worked today, I worked on my business, I worked on transcripts for my full-time job, but in the middle of the day, I took a break, I took the dogs out, we went on a walk. Like, it was super nice. I had time. I was on my own time, so I could pause. I took some pictures, you know, like getting the right angle, getting the right light. I wasn't in a hurry, and it was amazing. It was a beautiful, awesome day. And those types of days are the days that I love the most. And so the whole goal of this, like, or purpose of that exercise was not just to get warm, fuzzy thoughts, really. All those are nice. But it was more to identify where growing your business and developing that time freedom and the financial freedom can give you the freedom to do more of those things that you love. You know, like Sarah, going on trips with friends and, or going out with friends and just hanging out, you know, like it takes time and it takes money, right? Time and money. Car. Sorry?
I said in a car. I need a new car. Yes,
it takes a lot of things. Right? And sometimes like we don't realize how much we miss out on or what really the opportunities would be because we're so used to working, you know, or whatever it is that you do. But building your business really has the power to give you that freedom. And that's really what it's all about. You know, it's about freedom and it's about owning your time and being the girl boss, right? That owns her time and can do with it what she wants. That's my goal. So, okay. But did everybody enjoy it at least? You don't want to talk about it? Enjoy it?
Okay. Yes.
Okay. All right. Well, I enjoyed looking at all of them. I did. Okay. So let's talk about goals. And what I'm going to do is go over how to set goals. And I think with our happiness board, kind of figuring out like what it is that we want more to do more out of life and what we want more will help you focus in on your business goals as well. But I'm going to talk about how to set goals, what they look like, what a real goal looks like a goal that you want to set, because it's, and let me preface this whole conversation by kind of sharing with you like where I've come in my business. But when I first started, like I remember having these goal planning talks and we'd get on and they'd be like, what's your goal, Mary? And I'd be like, I'm going to be a 5-star by next year, you know? And then everyone would be like, yay, Mary's going to be a 5-star. And that was it. And there was no like direction. Okay, you have this goal, this awesome goal to be a 5-star coach. What does it take to get there? Right? Because without the what does it take to get there or the plan in place, you're not going to get there. It's great to say like, I'm going to drive to New York City. But if I don't have a map and I don't know where I'm going, probably not going to get there. Right? So, or at least it's going to take me a heck of a lot longer than it should. So what I want to try to like help you guys with is just really focusing on how to set goals, what they should look like, and how to then create a plan to get to them. And the way I'm going to talk about reverse engineering our goals, and I'm going to use a specific example of reverse engineering how to get to diamond rank, because I know a lot of people really want that. You want to get to diamond. But the way that you do it, the process of reverse engineering is true across the board for whatever goal you want to reverse engineer. But if Diamond or any other goal is really on your list, you might want to get out a pen and pencil, because we're going to be going through some steps. Okay, so first, I got to make sense of my notes here. All right, so goal setting. And have you guys heard of SMART goals, setting SMART goals? Amanda shoots herself in the head. No. This is important. Okay. So SMART goal, it's an acronym, right? SMART stands for specific, meaningful, and you'll see them different words sometimes, but my list is specific, meaningful, actionable or action-oriented, realistic, and timely. All right, so I'm going to go through and just kind of talk a little bit about each one of those. So specific, again, you can't just say like, I want to make $1 million. Like I want to be a millionaire by 2017, right? Like we need something more specific and, you know, identifying really detailed goals and the details of the goals. So highly specific and detailed, and it should answer what and where. When you're thinking about it, like what's my goal? I want to be a diamond coach, or I want to be a star diamond, or I want to hit premier in 2017. So identify a very specific goal. This goal should be meaningful, meaning it's specific to you. It matters to you. And like Trina said on the call or on her video, if you set a goal for yourself, and then you see somebody else set one, like maybe you set your goal to be diamond and then your friend set hers to be 2-star diamond. Don't go and change your goal. Like it should be your goal. And that's another thing where I'm going to talk about a little later is comparison and really not falling into the comparison trap. But this should be meaningful to you and it should fall in line with your life goals and your values and your morals, right? So make sure that when you set this goal, it matters, because if it doesn't matter to you and it's not your specific goal that aligns with your purpose, you're not going to have the drive and motivation to go after it. You just won't. You won't. You'll want to do something else. So if you set a goal and every time you think about it, you get like a headache and you feel sick to your stomach, or I don't know, like it's maybe that's not the right goal for you. Right? It should be something that you're excited about. Like maybe you're a little nervous because it's a big thing, but you're excited to give it a try. So action oriented, this should be a goal that you can break down into steps. So understanding, to me, I mean, it seems like you need to really understand how to get there and to be able to make a plan to get there. And have those action steps in place to get you to the goal. And we're going to talk again, when we do our reverse engineering exercise, we're going to talk about that. It needs to be realistic. Now, this is one that I hesitate saying realistic because what was it? Will Smith said, realism is the killer of dreams. And I do kind of agree with him. But I think it kind of depends on you personally. I know for myself, if I want a specific goal, like say I want to be premier next year, I'm going to set my goal for elite because I truly believe in shooting for the stars so that you can land on the moon, right? Like if I know that I need to sign up 2 coaches to hit a specific goal, I'm going to shoot for 3 coaches, right? I always overshoot because I want to hit the goal. I don't want to barely come in, or I don't want to come in right underneath it. You know what I mean? Like overshooting is something that fits me. If you're somebody who gets very discouraged or depressed, if you set a goal and you don't hit it, maybe overshooting isn't for you and setting more realistically is for you. But realistic to me really just means, do I believe I can do it? If it's something that I just don't believe I can do, then that's not a realistic goal for me. But if I'm looking at it and I'm like, yeah, I know what I'm capable of. I know how many hours a day I can devote to this. This is something that I can do. I can do it. It might take extra work and it might be like a stretch, or it might make me get out of my comfort zone, but I can do it. Then that's more realistic. So timely, it needs to be timely. So meaning I'm not going to set a goal and just say like someday I want to earn $1 million, or sometime in the future I'm going to be a premier coach. No, I need a date. I need a goal date so that I can then, again, when we talk about our reverse engineering, I'm going to be able to work backwards from that date and go backwards to where I am now, so that I have those steps in place that's going to take for me to get there. Also, setting a timely goal and having that end date is important, because if you're just throwing numbers out there and then you're working on the same goal for year after year after year after year, it's very discouraging and very depressing, and it's not fun. I know, because I've done that. So make sure that it's something that you can realistically hit within a specific time frame. All right, so an example of a SMART goal. Going off of what I just said, I'm going to give you an example based on, again, reaching diamond rank. So in 2016, my goal is to reach diamond rank by recruiting. So here we're getting specific what I need to do by recruiting 12 new coaches. Again, this is me overshooting, right? It takes 8 to get to diamond, but I say shoot for 12, just me. By recruiting 12 new coaches by September of 2016, and helping at least 3 of them achieve emerald rank, which will allow me to earn $1,500 a month, which will cover my mortgage payment. This is the meaningful part, right? What does this mean to me? It's not just like, oh, this like crazy rank, like, oh, I like diamonds, right? Like, diamonds are a girl's best friend. I'll shoot for diamond. No, let's make it like specific. Let's give it like that meaningful, like, why does it matter to you? What's it going to provide for you, right? So, which will $1,500 a month, which would cover my mortgage payment. I believe that I can do this because, number one, I've seen other people do it, and I'm willing to put in the work, and I know what it takes to get there. All right. So that's an example of a SMART goal. And I'm going to skip over this and come back to this. All right. So actually I'm not, I'm going to stay on my course. All right, so let's talk about reverse engineering for a minute. Does everybody, I can't see everybody because some people are on the phone, but I assume that you all know what I mean when I say reverse engineering, taking the furthest, the goal, like as if I'm there today, wherever that is, my date. So say January 1st, 2017, where I want to be, and then working it backwards to where I am today and creating milestones along the way. It requires understanding what it takes, right? Because if I don't understand what it takes to get there, how am I going to work backwards and set milestones? So if you have a goal for, like, say, premier coach or elite coach, you need to understand what it takes to be elite. You need to figure it out. Go into the Beachbody FAQs. All you have to do is put in elite qualifications, premier qualifications, but research the heck out of that and understand how it works. Because if you don't understand how it works, you're not going to know what you need to do, right? So we're going to talk about diamond tonight, but I just wanted to throw that out there in case there are other people who are shooting for higher goals than just diamond coach this year. You have to understand where you're going, okay? So step one is identifying, this is for reverse engineering. Step one is you need to identify your end goal. So I put, again, timely, put a time on that. When do I want to achieve this goal? All right. So, let's say for purposes of our example, that my goal is to be a diamond coach by October 15th of this year. All right. So basically 10 months from now. Step two, you have to identify what it means. All right. What, and that's again what I was talking about earlier. What does it take to become a diamond coach? So we know that it's me as a coach sponsoring at least 8 coaches who are active, right? 4 on each side. They all have to be active. And this is why I say shoot for more than what you, the bare minimum that you need, because the worst thing in the world would be to get to October 15th and have all the other qualifications except, you know, somebody dropped their Shakeology order. You know what I mean? Like, that would really suck. So I say shoot for 12, all right? To be a diamond coach, you need 2 emeralds, 1 on each side, right? So as you're building your team, it's important to be building evenly. And if you know that you're signing somebody up and they're telling you, and again, you can't sometimes predict these things, but you can make good educated guesses. If you know that or feel like this person's going to be a real rock star and they're really going to push and they're going to work their business really hard, try to strategically place those people, right? So if I've got 2 in a row that I know they want to work, they want to go for this, I'm not going to put them both on the same side. I'm going to split them up, put 1 on each side, because I'm trying to get my team built evenly for my rank, right? Because if we get 2 emeralds on one side, that's not diamond. You need 1 on each side. Again, overshooting, I would go for 3. Really push. And honestly, obviously, as you're working, if you have 4 coaches who are really working and they're like, I want to get to Emerald, I want to rock this business, you're going to work with all of them, obviously. Okay, so step number 3, you're going to create a plan of action. All right. So if I need, or create your plan of action. So the 12 coaches by, I'm sorry, I'm trying to understand my notes. 12 coaches by October 15th, that's my plan, okay? So if I want to be a diamond coach in 2016, I want to overshoot again. I don't want to set my end date for December 31st, right? I'm going to set my end date sooner so that I have time to hit that goal. Step number 4, divide so you can conquer. So here's where we talk about creating milestones along the way so that you aren't just throwing out this goal of like, I need 12 coaches, and then here we hit August and you still need, you know, 9 of them, right? We need to create milestones along the way and set small goals that we can hit. And when you do this, you guys, when you create like little bite-sized chunks and small milestones along the way, that big, hairy, crazy goal is suddenly not so hard because you're working on it consistently and you're taking it bit by bit, chunk by chunk. It's like when you lose weight. Like when I started my weight loss journey, I wanted to lose 50 pounds and I looked at that goal and it felt like Mount Everest. It felt like 150 pounds. I mean, it in my mind was like a big deal. So what I did is I broke it down in 5-pound chunks. You can hit 5 pounds in 2 or 3 weeks, right? And then you get to celebrate and you feel really great because you hit that milestone and you get to take a picture and it says, you know, your number, right? So create these milestones based on the goal that you're trying to achieve. So if we're trying to get 12 coaches by October 15th of 2016, that's 9 months. Right? If I divide 12 coaches by 9 months, it's 1.3 coaches a month. So again, overshoot. I'm going to try to hit 2 coaches a month, right? Can't get 1.3, right? It's a little difficult. They might have a problem with that. So, you know, 2 coaches a month. And if you do that, you'll way overshoot your goal. And that's a good thing. That's a very good thing. So I need to also help a coach get to Emerald by teaching them what I did to get to Emerald. And I need to get my Emeralds by June, my 2nd Emerald by August, and then my goal is my 3rd Emerald coach by October. All right? So again, breaking these things down so that I know what I'm working toward. Step number 5 is understand the process and also making this measurable, All right. So when we set goals like we do in step number four and we create those milestones, we're making this measurable, because if I get to the end of February and I didn't get my two coaches, that's, I can look at that and go, okay, I missed the mark, right? It's measurable. So with tracking and really like understanding what it takes, I highly recommend the Power of Three or the BAT. There's so many different ways to track. I created my own Power of 15. They're all loaded up in our team page, or you can go to the Beachbody FAQ and search the business activity tracker, because that's in there, and the FAQs. But you have to understand what it takes to sign up a coach, right? Because this business is all about duplication. It's all about recruiting coaches and building business partners. And so in order to do that, we got to understand how it works, okay? So this is, again, just another step in our reverse engineering. I know that sign-up rates for coaches is about 10%. So 10% of the invitations I send out are going to be a yes on average. So in order for me to get one coach, I need to invite 10 people, right? So if I want to sign up two coaches in a month, I'm going to invite about 25 people to my business opportunity. In order to be recruiting coaches, you also need to be doing the three vital behaviors. So we need to be inviting daily, right? Which is what we just talked about. We need to be proof the products work and show our results. We need to be, as Trina said, bathing daily in personal development, like swim in the sea of personal development. That is so huge, you guys. That's something I didn't do in the beginning, and I can't even tell you what a difference it is. And it's in me. It's a difference in me from my personal development. But what my business is based on me, right? So my me, I shine through, and that affects everything I touch, right? If you want to be enthusiastic, excited, an overcomer, somebody who's crushing goals, someone who's excited and driven, get in your personal development. That should be number one on the list. And I heard somebody else say that a long time ago, that the three vital behaviors should be flipped around. And I kind of agree. Personal development is last on the list, but it really should be first. That's where you should start. Most of us come into this thing with, you know, limiting self-beliefs that you don't even realize you have. You really don't. I didn't. So personal development is the way to get through a lot of that stuff. It also gives you a great way to interact with people who want to be involved and get them involved, like being positive, being a positive influence on them. You also need customer satisfaction. All right. So I know we have a lot of people on our team who have joined Beachbody as a coach before they were really a customer. But we also have a lot of people on our team who were customers first, including myself. And I can tell you, if you can get somebody plugged into your challenge group and get them amazing results with their program and with Shakeology, and get them plugged in and loving that and excited about it, they're going to want to be a coach. They're just going to want to, there's something that happens inside of you when you get some results like that. And when you find something that's life-changing, you want to share it with people. It's just the way we're wired. We want to share it with people. So get those challengers, man. Every challenge pack you sell, that's a coach potential. That is a potential for a coach. And we have to start looking at it like that. So when we put them in our challenge group, that's coach preparation, right? Challenge groups are coach preparation. That's the, gosh, this is going to sound terrible, but it's the hunting ground for coaches. Like, if you want to go like trolling for coaches, look first in your customer list. You got a lot of people in there who are drinking their Shakeology and they love it and they're getting results. So again, what does it take to sign up a coach? You have to be positive. You have to be enthusiastic. You have to be excited about this. And this is something that I think we don't even realize we do, but we decide for people, or we have this preconceived idea that they're not going to like what we have to offer, or they're not going to be interested. And we might even go, you know, I'm going to invite them because I know I have to, and I've got this empty space on my business activity tracker and I need to fill it out and I need to put a name in there. So I'm just going to send this invitation. You know, you guys, we make it way too hard. People are interested in what we're excited about. So if you approach somebody and you're just like, yeah, they're, yeah, I have this sneak peek thing going on. You know, if you're not busy, they're probably not going to want to be interested. You know what I mean? Like, if you're inviting, and you're getting a lot of no, above and beyond, like I said, that 10%, right? We're not talking about that. But if you're getting like zip, you might want to check your attitude and check how you're coming into the conversation. Because how we come into it is extremely important, and people can feel it across the keyboard. I don't care what you say. If you have a frown on your face, they feel it, all right? If you don't think they're going to be interested, they're probably not going to be. But just being enthusiastic and really like embracing the fact that what we have is something that's super powerful. It's super awesome. It has the power to change people's lives. Why wouldn't they want to join our team? Really? Why wouldn't they? This is fantastic. I get to help people. I get to, you know, earn a substantial income. Why wouldn't you want to join my team? Approach every person that way, and I think you'll see different results. The last thing I wanted to talk about is being authentic. So when you're signing people up or you're talking to people about coaching, it's very important that you're genuinely you and genuinely authentic and understand yourself and understand what makes you tick. And I think that happiness board will help a little bit in that area, but understand your own interests and your likes and your dislikes. And make sure that you're portraying that on Facebook and on Instagram and whatever social media platform you're using, but be you, all right? Don't hide. It doesn't benefit anybody if you hide who you are. You might sign up coaches, but they're not going to get you. And then you're going to be like, how come nobody wants to work? How come nobody wants to do anything? Well, maybe because they're not the right people, right? Okay, so I want to switch gears a little bit. Actually, I'm going to take this in little chunks. I'm going to unmute you guys. Does anybody have any questions about reverse engineering? Did that all make sense? Yeah? Okay. Anyone want to talk about, I know we're at like a half an hour right now, and I have a bunch more stuff that I wrote down, but I don't want to keep you guys too long. Anybody want to talk about your goals? Like, anything? Oh my God, you guys are so quiet.
Mary, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
It's Candace.
Hey, Candace.
Hey, I can talk about my goals. I don't know if you want to want me to say them or some of them or.
Or just like, you know, if you don't want to like say what, it's up to you. Like, I'm just curious, like where everybody's headed, you know?
Well, I definitely want to hit diamond like tomorrow, but, I want to hit diamond by no later than the 1st of March, and I want to sponsor 3 new coaches a month, and I want to hit Success Club 10 every month, and that's just what I've been jotting down. I'm driving home from LA, but I wanted to be able to just say a few of my goals.
Okay, thank you. Thanks for sharing. And like Candace just said, you know, breaking that down again, like, 3 coaches a month, like understanding what it takes is really important. But yeah, thanks for sharing, Candace. And you know what? Like, I totally believe you're going to do it. I totally believe you're going to do it.
Me too.
Yeah.
Thank you. I'm excited.
You've got this, girl. Like, you totally.
I got it. I got it in the bag.
Yes, you do. It's in the bag. Purchased and paid for. Anybody else?
Me, I'll talk.
Okay.
Hi. My goal, and it's almost scary to say it, but my goal is I'd like to hit 3-star diamond. Candace, I can't wait for you to be one of my stars. That'll be awesome. But I really want to see Angelina and Melissa. Angelina has been with me for a while, but Melissa, one of my new coaches, I really want to work on focusing on them and seeing them hit their goals as well. Yeah, that's where I'm headed, 3 stars. And so I know with that, though, I have to keep adding more and more people because, like you said, it's easy to just kind of, like, sit back and be like, ooh, I got 8. All right. So obviously adding more coaches and just really focusing on those who want to work the business. Because right now I have 8 coaches, but they don't all want to work the business necessarily. I have some discount coaches on there. So I'm focusing more this year on recruiting people who want to work the business and really focusing on helping them to hit diamond as well. Mm-hmm. So that's my goal.
Awesome. And you know what? I believe you're going to do that too. I believe, you know what, you guys? There is nobody who believes in you more than me. Like, I know all of you. I see you hitting these goals, and it makes me super excited because, like you just said, Amanda, like, wanting to see your coaches succeed and hit their goals, that's where I'm at. Like, I want whatever it is that you want, I want it. I want it for you just as bad as you want it. And, I'm sure you all know that I'm here for you. You know, like, whatever I can do to help you, I absolutely will. If I could do it for you, I would do it for you, but I can't. But, you know, that's like, it's just super exciting. When I've seen so much growth over the last year, and it's really kind of overwhelming to me. So I'll share with you a little bit about my goals this year, and I've set them really high, so I'm kind of scared. And I need everybody. It's kind of like, and this is this way for any rank that you're shooting for, but have you ever tried to push a car by yourself? Like, it's like impossible, right? Or have you ever like remember, is everybody old enough on this call? Maybe not. I'm getting older. But you remember the old merry-go-rounds? Where you like pile everybody up on they're illegal now for some weird reason. You know, they pile everybody up on the merry-go-round, and then one person or two is out there, and you that first, like, getting it started is so hard, right? But once you get it going, you just keep pushing, and maybe a few other people hop off and they start pushing with you. Many can lighten the load. And that's just the way it is. And if you're reaching for goals with your rank, you're reaching for goals with your income, the more people you have on your team helping you and working with you and really, really joining as a team together and working together as a team, it makes it doable. Whereas by yourself, it's really not. So for me, my goals this year, I want to hit elite, which means that I need to be a 5-star diamond coach by I think it's November, the middle of November. So this is like a big goal, and it's one that I've set before, not gonna lie. But it's one that I've never reverse engineered, and I've never like took the time to figure out what does it take for me to hit this. And I've done that. And so I have my goal set, and that's where I'm headed. And I'm excited to do my best and just see where we end up at the end of the year. Again, like I said, I'm not, you know, if I don't hit elite, I'm not going to cry. If I hit premier, I would be pretty jazzed about that. But that's my goal. So,
To get elite, it's just being a 5-star diamond. Just being.
No.
But I mean, there's other things too, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's a point system, which is why I was saying if that's one of your goals or premier is one of your goals, you want to go and check out what it takes. But there's 3 categories where you get points. One is like your personal sponsor. coaches, Hitting Success Club, your coaches that you sign up in that calendar year, their personal volume counts, and then the accumulated team volume across the board as compared to the previous year. So there's three ways to get points, but it's not just rank. But the truth is that if I get my team to 5-star this year, I'll have plenty of points. That alone for me would be enough. Definitely. Anyway, so that's my goal, and I don't mind sharing it with you guys because I need people to hold me accountable. And
you need diamonds.
I need diamonds. I do. I do need diamonds. I do. And, you know, I guess it's funny because somebody told me one time, like, you know, I was pushing for a goal. I can't remember now what it was. And somebody told me, oh, you should reach out to your coaches and ask them to help you. And I remember at the time thinking, like, that felt so, like, selfish in a way, like, to ask somebody else to help me. But when you really think about it, I'm not asking you to donate your blood to me, right? Like, whatever you do to build your business and to reach your goals is helping me. And just like me help me reaching my goal is going to help you too, right? It's all a team effort. And it's like I was saying, like, one person trying to push a car is really hard, but when you get four or five people behind that sucker, it goes pretty good, right? It's not so hard. So yeah, like, you know, it's nice to have many hands now on this team. Like, it's been a long time coming, so it's exciting. Like, at one point we had like 8 people on this call. That's exciting. Progress. Is there anything that I can help you guys with right now? Does anybody have? I'm not sure who's on the call right now. Anybody have anything that, you know, you think would help you reach your goals that we could do as a team? I see all these nervous faces when I ask questions.
I think when you share different videos, training videos, that in and of itself is helpful. Like, there's a couple that I have saved, like, on recruiting that I'm going to go back and listen to. You know, things like that is really helpful. So when you find something that you're like, oh, this would be cool to share it, and, you know, then when we watch it, it's valued information.
Okay. That's one of my goals this year. I know a lot, most of the time I just post the videos directly into Facebook. My goal this year is to post them to YouTube because I've set up my YouTube channel. So now if you go onto my channel, there's a whole business section with business videos on different aspects of the business, which is a resource if you guys want to check that out. But from now on, I'm going to be uploading those short little videos I do for the team. I'm going to be doing them to YouTube first. That way they can be categorized and it's easier to find them because in the Facebook page, things just get lost. Stuff.
Okay. I have a question, not about what you just asked, but last night I actually tried to set up like business hours, you know, and like, okay, I'm going to work on the business from, and it was like 9:30 to 10:30. And then here it was like 11:30 and I was still doing stuff, but I didn't feel like it was like focused, you know, like I would send out all these messages. Like, we started a clean eating challenge, so I sent out messages to everybody who I don't know, you know, because I posted it to one of our community groups. So I was sending messages to those people I don't know. Well, then I feel like I get so tied up in a message and a conversation. I have like 8 conversations going and I'm not sending messages about recruiting or, you know, whatever, doing other things that I need to do for the business. Like, how do you, I know you said you have hours that you work, but how do you stay focused and not find yourself wrapped up in all these conversations that's taking hours and hours? I mean, obviously we need to respond to people, but.
Right. I don't know. So, I think where it gets difficult is when you have a list of things that you want to accomplish on your time, but you attack them all at once. So if I send, you know, if it's my time to invite people to the business, I'm not going to be talking to my challenge group at the same time. Because you're right. If I start a conversation in challenge group, if I start a conversation with a customer, I want to be there in the conversation. I don't want to send them, hey, how are you doing? And they respond back right away. And then I'm like, MIA for an hour. Because that sends a message to them that I really didn't care. Right? So I guess I would say is just being like super laser focused on the task at hand. You know what I mean? Like an hour to spend on your business. Spend 20 minutes sending messages to people. And then when the 20 minutes is up, cut it off. Just like you had to walk out the door to go to work. You know what I mean? Like it's, I'm moving on to my next item on the list. And that's coach recruiting or whatever it is. Does that help?
Yeah.
It's hard. It is hard. And I know like something that really distracts me a lot. And I've heard a lot of coaches say like, turn notifications off. Because it does. Like I've been sitting here on this video and my notifications, I forgot to turn them off. They're popping up on the corner and it is, it's distracting, you know? So yeah, you can turn the notifications off and just stick to the plan. Like I have a plan for my time. I'm going to stick to it. I don't know if that helps.
I'm really excited, Mary, and I'm glad that you did this call. It took like everything for me to get on it tonight. I like started dinner at like 4:10. But anyway, I'm really excited, and I'm going to do what I need to do to get to my goal, and yeah, I'm going to be that leader that I think people under me have needed that I haven't been, and I look to your example, so thank you very much.
Oh, well, I'm very excited, and I appreciate that. It's so important to be a leader to your team. Even like Stephanie, you have two coaches. You're a leader. You're a leader on your team. And I know, I think some people, they get kind of freaked out about that. You know, like, oh, if I recruit people, now I'm responsible for them. Yes, you are. Doesn't mean you're not going to make mistakes. I still make mistakes. Like, nobody's perfect. You know what I mean? But you learn as you go. But you'll hear a lot, like the speed of the leader is the speed of the pack. And it's really true. If you want your coaches doing something, you really need to be doing it yourself. You want your coaches to hit Success Club, you really should be hitting Success Club yourself. Like, just one of those things, you know, if you want your coaches inviting, you should be inviting. And they can tell when you're not doing what you're telling them to do. Like, it's kind of like a mom telling a kid to do something that, like, well, you're not doing it, you know. But I think leadership is really important. And I know I mentioned, at the end of last year that we were going to be doing 3-day focus groups. I haven't forgotten about that. I'm working on it right now. But one of the topics I want to cover really soon, like in the next, probably next month, is leadership and just some, you know, good training on how to be a good leader and different things you can do. Step up. But don't think that you got to wait until you're a diamond coach to be step up and be a leader for your coaches. Absolutely not. If you've hit emerald rank, you know what it takes to hit emerald rank. Teach your coaches how to hit emerald rank. You know, it's really about taking what you've learned and passing it on and being good at that. And it doesn't mean you have to know everything. It just means you have to share what you do know. And that's something that I didn't do for the longest time. So I'm saying that with a whole lot of love for myself and grace for myself, because there are so many people that I feel like I let down. So many people that I feel like I really let down. And, you know, it is a big responsibility when you're helping someone build a business. So yes, I'm excited. So I have a whole nother like 2 pages that I wrote down, but I'm just going to stop here because I don't want to keep you guys too late. And I know like what we talked about, like where I was going next was a little bit off the subject that we covered. So maybe it'll be good for kind of like ruminate and marinate in goal setting and reverse engineering. But if you have a goal that you want to reach and you're like a little stuck on the whole reverse engineering thing, let me know and we can work through it together. Okay. All I ask is that you figure out what it takes to reach that goal. All right. The plan part, like, or what it means. So if you come to me and you ask me to help you with reverse engineering it, I'm more than willing to do that, but I want you to understand what it means and what it takes before you come to me. Right. Does that make sense? All right, so have final words, anything else to say? Anyone? Comments? No? All right, well, I just wanted to end this by saying that I am so in love with all of you guys. Like, you know the emoji with the hearts and the eyes? That's what I feel like most of the time. I see your posts and I see what you're doing in your groups, and thank you for adding me to your groups. I try to like comment here and there when I can, but I know I don't do a great job of that because I'm in a lot of different groups. Trust me, I see what you're doing, and you guys are amazing. You guys really are, all of you. Our team has some amazing rock stars on it and up and coming people that are brand new that are really kicking butt already. And it's, I was talking to Missy, I had my call with Missy, because I have a coach, and I had my call with her last week on Friday, and she told me, she's like, man, Mary, she's like, I've been watching your team grow this last year, and she's like, you have some amazing rock stars on your team, and it felt really good to hear that from someone who is, you know, a 10-star diamond coach. It felt really great, and it was like, it just made my day to hear that. So I wanted to pass that on to you guys because it's all you. It's all you, right? You're the rock stars. So I know sometimes it can be a little frustrating, and I know sometimes, especially when you're first starting to recruit, it can be really frustrating because you just want everybody to want this as bad as you do. And the truth is, not everybody does, and sometimes that's hard to accept, and it is. It's hard to accept, but I want you to know that that's normal, right? It's a growing pains, and everyone goes through that, okay? But like I was telling Stephanie before everybody else hopped on the call tonight, the people who are guaranteed to fail are the ones who quit, right? That's the only way that you're guaranteed to fail is if you just give up. So stay in the game, like, no matter what. And I can tell you from where I'm sitting, like, somebody who's taken way longer than I expected to get to where I am right now, I'm so glad I stayed in the game. So.
Can I say one more thing?
Yes.
Sorry. I know I talked to you last week about how I was frustrated. Like, I had some really close friends who they were just being jerks, like funny jerks, but they were like, why don't you go take a selfie? Like, oh my gosh, go take a selfie, you know, like making comments like that. And I was like, that's rude, but whatever, I'll go take my selfie. Anyway, I was like really frustrated with that. But I didn't say anything. I just like shook it off. Well, that same friend, like one of my close friends, she messaged me yesterday and we were talking and she was like, so, hey, do you need a workout partner today? I'm like, are you kidding me? Yeah, sure, come on over. So she came over and did yoga with me yesterday. And I texted her this morning, like, hey, how are you feeling? She's like, good. You need somebody else to help you out today? I'm like, yeah, if you want to come. So she came and we did cardio fix. And so she's like, I probably should just like buy this program because I'm not going to be able to come over here every day. I was like, what? So like, which, and she just got back from a big trip, and I know financially she can't afford it right now, but I told her, I said, you know what? I don't want you to think I'm trying to sell you on this. I said, you're more than welcome to come over here every day and work out with me. You know, I said, I appreciate you reaching out and wanting to do that. She's like, well, I know I need a workout to reach my goal. She's like, so what time do you want to do it tomorrow? Like when I get off work, should I come over? And I was just like, yes. And so just to know, like, just people are going to talk smack and say stuff, but you don't know like when they're going to change their mind. They might not ever, but they might too, you know, and it might not be so awkward of a thing. So that's my little words of wisdom.
Thank you for telling me that. That's really great. And I want to give you kudos for not just responding with a like, well, you know, you have to take a selfie, right?
and I took one like yesterday. I posted the look who decided to join me doing yoga. And I wanted to be like, ha, go take a selfie.
Yeah.
And so today I videoed the workout. She's like, you better not put me in your video.
That is so awesome. Well, yeah. You know what? And that really goes to show that a lot of times when people talk smack or when people hate on you for what you're saying, it's because it's really casting the spotlight on them. And they know that they should be doing it too, but they don't really want to. And so they talk smack to you, right? Mm-hmm. Or offer you pizza, right? Or invite you out for chicken wings, all right? So, no, that's really great. That's a great, thank you for sharing that. That's awesome.
You're welcome.
Yeah, because that's a big thing. I know a lot of people, I've never really had haters in my business. I had one encounter with a family member. I think I've told you guys about it, but I wouldn't say like people who outright are like really rude to my face, but I definitely know I have my doubters. I have big doubters, right? And I'm sure I have the haters too. They're just not, you know, in my face about it. But I've had smack talk to me before, but anyway, you just have to have thick skin. And one of the calls, okay, if this is a problem for you guys, people talking smack or people like doubting you or people, you know, kind of like, isn't that a MLM? Like, what are you doing? You're crazy. There's a call. It's a call by Vito Lafata. I hope that's how he says his name. And I want to say it was maybe like in the last 3 months. I can find it. And it's on confidence. But it's called confidence, but he talks a lot about that. About how, you know, the people that we allow to influence us is really important. Like who you allow to influence you, and really asking yourself the kind of tough questions when somebody tries to offer you advice or whatever. Are you going the same direction I'm going? Is your life something that I would like to live? Like kind of that whole, like, if I'm having marriage trouble, I'm not going to ask the person who's 5 times divorced for marriage advice. Right? I'm going to go to somebody that I know they have a great relationship, right? Because that's what I want. I don't want the other, right? So when somebody's talking smack on you, on your business, like, are they somebody that you would like your life? Are they headed your direction? And if they're not, you know, sayonara, baby. I don't need to listen to your advice. I don't need it. Like, you know what I mean? I'm good. Now, if somebody who is somebody you respect and somebody that you look up to offers you advice, those are the people to listen to. It's not that you don't listen to anyone or you don't take advice from anyone, but just make sure you're listening to the right people, I guess. But that call was really good. It was a national wake-up call. And I want to say it was about confidence, but his name's Vito Lafata. Kind of a funny name for a fitness person. But anyway. Right. Anyway, all right, you guys, I'm gonna let you go because I know it's late, right on the East Coast especially. But I love you guys, and I'm here for you. All right. If there's anything I can do, you let me know, and I will be talking to you guys soon. All right. Have a nice night.